Hey guys, what's up? It's Exselsior Tech, and today I'm gonna give you guys just a little bit of information about me, and then I also have an announcement at the end. A little bit about me. First off, the name Exselsior Tech, or for you guys, Exselsior Tech, I realized that I spelled Exselsior wrong, and that is because I made it my Minecraft username, actually, is the first thing I did. And with a C, the Excelsior, the C was taken. Like the right spelling with the C was taken, so I used an S instead. And then that was my username, and so I transfer that over to Fortnite and whatever. That's my username for different things. And then I kept the same spelling for YouTube, not only because for consistency, but also because that with the C was. Somebody, it's not like a snake, it's not taken. You can have multiple names on YouTube, but someone else had is already using it, so I didn't want to confuse the two channels. So that's why my name is spelled wrong. I did try it, not optimal, but I can live with it. Right now, if you type in my name exactly as it is, it'll say searching for Excelsior with a C, like the correct way. Search instead for what you typed in, and that's the only way I can find my channel, so that's kind of unfortunate. Alright, a little bit about me. So, my name is Seth, or Excelsior Tech, if you want to call me that, or the Excelsior or whatever, but my actual name is Seth, and my brother is Darren, who's Tater Tot. Once he changes his name, he might have a channel, I kind of forget actually if they actually made one, but he makes videos for it. I don't know if he actually has a channel yet. But if he does, I'll probably be collabing with him and such, with my gaming channel. I live in on the East Coast, United States. I'm American, and I live sort of in the. I live within several hours of Philly, so that's kind of where I am, Philadelphia. I'm 18 years old as of now. I just graduated from high school, this a little bit ago. I want to get into a career in IT. So, probably get some sort of certifications, whatever I need there. As of right now, I'm working at a hardware store close to my house. I'll be working there at least for the summer, see if they have something for me more than just what I'm doing now. More of a full-time career kind of job. Some of my interests are obviously computers, YouTube, but I like to follow sports. Right now, the NBA Finals are finishing up. More of a football fan, to be honest, but some of my friends like basketball, so I follow it too. Not a Raptors fan, but go Raptors. Now for the announcement. So not a huge announcement. It's not like I went and bought a house or bought a like $2,000 camera or whatever, but I bought a laptop. It's a HP Pavilion gaming laptop. So it's a gaming laptop, but I didn't want to get one of those gaming laptops that are obviously a gaming laptop, like the somewhat like the Predator or whatever. It's like this thick and has RGB everywhere, and the heat sinks are like it's heat sinks like flying out the back, and decoration on the back of the laptop, like the top of the other side of the screen. I didn't want one of those. I was debating between the Dell G3 and the Pavilion Gaming, and I ended up getting the Pavilion. It's a little bit, I think it looks better, but still not like too much, and it was a better processor and such. A little bit more expensive, but only by $50. So the G3 is very not gamer looking, with the exception of like the outline WASD keys and such. But yeah, it looked kind of plasticky, so I got the Pavilion instead. So let me give you guys a little bit of the specs I got. A quick tip for when you're buying a laptop or any computer, really. If you want to save money, don't do the upgrades that you can do yourself later. So if you have money, do the upgrade then, because it will save you money. Because on some things at least, it could save you money to actually do it then. So you're not like taking out a small SSD and putting in a big one, because then that small SSD you didn't have to pay for. If you can afford the big one, then it's cheaper to put it in, to do it when you buy the computer or laptop, when you customize it. But for example, for RAM, so for my laptop, There's an option to get 12 and 16 gigs of RAM, but I only did 8 because there's two slots, and I only put in, and so there's only one, and there's an 8 gig stick in one of the slots. So later, if I want to, if I need to, I can put in another 8 thing, and then I have 16 or 4 or whatever. So that's a little tip. Same with the storage. If there's so mine, I have 1 gig, sorry, 1 terabyte hard drive, and then 16 gigs of Intel Optane. So later, if I want to, I'm not even sure how much faster it'd be, actually. But if I want to, I can put in an SSD in that M.2 slot where the Optane is right now. I might end up doing that. I kind of think I will. I might put in more RAM as well. So, what are the specs? So, I have them here. It's a screenshot of my specs. So, it's an HP Pavilion gaming laptop, 15-inch, 15T hexa core with 2 gigabytes discrete, whatever that means. So, I did not get a CD drive or DVD drive. It's like external. I did not get that. So, let me just start with the processor. Intel Core i7. 8750H, so it's 8th gen i7, pretty fast. It's a laptop chip, so it's not as fast as like the 8700K or whatever, but it's still fast. And then the graphics card, GeForce GTX 1050 with 2 gigabytes dedicated GDDR5, so it's not incredibly fast, but it's enough that you can actually play most games well. At decent settings, decent frame rate. I would have preferred a 1050 Ti, but that wasn't an option, and that would have been more expensive as well. The only advantage, the G3 I was talking about, is that it had 4 gigs dedicated instead of 2. That's the GPU and CPU. So the storage, I already said, it's a 1 TB 5400 RPM SATA drive, and then 16 gigs of Optane, which I'm pretty sure that's an M.2 slot, PCIe NVMe. The keyboard's backlit. So the only thing I upgraded, the color, I changed it from green to white to make it look less gamer, so I can take it somewhere and use it as like a business laptop or whatever, or just whatever, anything that's not gaming. It doesn't look like I'm a gamer too much. So I got a white. It's white instead of green. So that was $10, I guess. I've kind of forgot about that. That was an upgrade, technically. But then the only other upgrade I got was the camera. I upgraded the camera to an infrared, added an infrared camera so I can use face unlock. So as I said, 8 gigs of RAM as of now. I'll have this spec sheet here, probably a screenshot of it in my video so you can just look at it. I did not upgrade the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth to Bluetooth 5.0 because I can do that later. I can put in a different little thing if I want to. I don't really think I'll need it anyway. Windows 10 Home. Like I said, the HP TrueVision FHD IR camera and then a dual-array microphone. The battery is a 3-cell 52.5 watt-hour battery, so it's not that much. I was reading reviews that you can probably get 4 hours of use out of a laptop, which it has a pro it has a powerful stuff. That's what that's how it's gonna be. And then I said the processor, GPU, and it's 15.6-inch diagonal FHD IPS anti-glare micro edge WLED backlit 1920 by 1080 display. I was debating upgrading the display to 144 Hz. I decided not to though because that would have been a lot of money, and I was trying to save money on this. So I got money from my parents and grandparents and relatives from graduating, and that's what I used to buy this laptop. It was about, oh, it was on sale, or there was a sale, 150 off, and there was also a sale for $30 off, but I accidentally missed that sale. I thought it ended on the 8th, but it actually ended before that. But the 150 ended on the 8th, so I ordered on the 6th, I believe, or 7th of June. It was at the end, it was 740. Could have been 710, it's unfortunate. But 740 plus tax, so it was actually at the end 785 about. That's my announcement and a little bit about me. Hope you guys enjoyed. Like, comment, anything I should be reviewing in the future. Subscribe so you know when those reviews come out. I think I'll be reviewing some small things soon. And that's about it. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.